WJLA TV. This is News 7 at 11.
It's a parent's worst nightmare come true. Someone assaulted teenagers right in their own homes, and the neighborhood tonight is in shock.
Pesticides designed to make life and living easier may harbor dangers that could threaten your life. It's a News 7 special. Good evening, everyone. I'm Paul Berry.
And I'm Kathleen Matthews. Thanks for joining us. We begin tonight in the Pimmit Hills area of Fairfax County, where tonight residents are being warned to lock their windows when they go to bed.
A break-in artist is on the loose, and his intentions are not good. News 7's Dale Solly in our newsroom says there's only one thing on this sicko's mind. Dale?
One thing, Paul, and one way of trying to get it. And that's why parents who have teenage daughters have got to pay attention.
Hey, we must be coffee.
Nestled in this safe-looking, safe-feeling Falls Church neighborhood, in among the neat one-floor homes built after the war, on Heilman Road, where families grow, there is something no one figured would ever turn up here.
We were feeling pretty good and pretty safe walking our baby through the neighborhood this evening, and now we've changed our view tonight.
At 1 o'clock Thursday morning, a big man in dark clothing climbed through an open first floor bedroom window and surprised a 15-year-old girl.
She's asleep in her bedroom when she awakes to find a man in the bedroom with her. The man assaults her and attempts to put his hand over her mouth, but she is able to scream, which causes the man to flee back out through her bedroom window.
This is an area where neighbors watch out for one another.
That's a real surprise and a shock to hear something like that this close.
But Thursday's incident wasn't the first. Fairfax County Police patrolled Pimmit Drive, where a month ago, a big man in dark clothing assaulted another 16-year-old sleeping teenager after finding her window open. Her screams chased him off. But the victim's friends now say this is not the time for silence about Pimmit Hills' problem.
And I know how she is kind of in personality, and I think she wouldn't want to reveal it to anybody. But really, I think it's important that they should, to let other girls our age know what's going on and, you know, ways that they can try to prevent it from happening to them.
Not a lot of leads in this at this point, other than this is a big man who wears dark clothing and breaks into houses at night. Look, it's a real temptation to want to, as the weather gets nicer now, go to bed and leave the windows open. Fairfax County Police tell us tonight, don't do it. It's better to lock the windows and sweat a little bit until they can get this guy off the streets, Paul and Kathleen.
Okay, thanks very much. Dale Solly reporting live from the newsroom.
Well, tonight, Fairfax County Police have released a composite sketch of a man who's wanted for the attempted abduction of two small children. It happened while the father was shopping at a Heckinger store in Burke, Virginia. When his 4-year-old son and 2-year-old daughter disappeared, he ran out to the parking lot. It was just in time to grab his daughter from a stranger. The suspect in this case is described as being in his mid-30s with curly hair and a mustache. He's about 5 feet 9 inches tall, driving a silver pickup truck. A pregnant woman fell out of a third-story apartment building today, breaking both of her legs. It took a D.C. squad team more than an hour to rescue her. The unidentified woman is currently at D.C. General Hospital, where she is in serious condition. According to hospital officials, however, her unborn baby is doing just fine.
Marine biologists may be closer to finding an answer tonight about the mysterious microorganism infecting fish on the eastern shore. Now, fish being pulled from the Pocomoke River are slowly showing ugly lesions, and the Maryland Department of Natural Resources has detected low levels of an organism called Fisteria in the river. Last summer, Fisteria killed more than 20,000 fish in Princess Anne County. Officials say more tests are needed before any conclusions can be made. It's the time of year to establish that lush and beautiful lawn. For many, it means using lawn chemicals, but some charge those toxic chemicals are killing more than bugs and weeds. Consumer investigative reporter Archie Kelly has more.
There are all kinds of harmful substances hidden in pesticide products.
We're surrounded by poisons. Pesticides were meant to kill.
And no one disputes they do kill very well. But the question now being asked, are they killing more than we know?
My husband died as a result of exposure to a lawn care pesticide that's still widely used.
Stories like these provide the motivation as homeowners and activists from across the nation organize to take on what they say is a lawn chemical industry out of control.
We've got a situation where the federal government is not adequately protecting people from exposure.
It's hard to get the word out. I mean, the industry's out there. This time of year, they're out there with the advertising and the literature.
The word that must get out, according to the National Coalition for the Misuse of Pesticides, is that the average homeowner needs to wake up.
I think people are very unaware. I think there's a massive marketing from the corporations selling these products, making it look innocuous.
But many of the products are anything but innocuous, according to Ruth Berlin of Annapolis and her son, Jesse.
I had numbness in my limbs. I lost some of my vision. I became very nauseous.
Berlin says both she and Jesse, who developed asthma, are still recovering from exposure to the insecticide malathion.
I become red, hot, and itchy. It's hard for me to breathe.
Right now, according to the anti-pesticide activists, many homeowners simply assume that if you can buy the product at the hardware store, it has been tested and approved and is okay for use around the home.
It's not okay. These chemicals are registered. They're not approved. They are dangerous. They do kill.
That's a view shared by Steve Howell of Natural Lawn of America, which emphasizes organic alternatives.
EPA doesn't approve anything. They simply register the product for use.
So the mere fact that something is found on a store shelf doesn't mean that it's safe and effective?
Absolutely not.
But companies like Pro Lawn Care of Towson say the risk is overblown, that virtually all the available chemicals can be used safely if used properly.
I think it's really a few very organized, active people that are making a lot of this, a lot of the making a lot of these statements.
One of those organized, active people is Tessa Hill of Minneapolis, who says whether you know it or not, lawn chemicals can kill you.
It's in the food, it's in the water, it's on the lawn, it's in the air we breathe.
With a 7 on Your Side consumer investigation, I'm Archie Kelly.
Thank you, Archie. Lawn care companies suggest you read and follow the directions carefully. Pesticides, as you just saw, can be very dangerous if mishandled or misused.
Tonight, Maryland police are looking for a motorist who may have caused a fire truck accident in Clinton, Maryland. 4 firefighters were injured when the truck jackknifed on Old Branch Avenue. The fire truck, with emergency lights and siren operating, was trying to avoid a car that was pulling out of a convenience store parking lot. Police say the car they are looking for is a Pontiac 6000 with Maryland handicapped license plates.
One of television's top crime shows is filmed in the state of Maryland. If you missed the season finale of Homicide, then you missed Maryland Governor Paris Glendinning's acting debut along with Baltimore Mayor Kurt Schmoke. Well, News 7's Horace Holmes takes us now behind the scenes.
It is a show conceived by a Baltimore newspaper writer, produced by a Maryland native, shot on the shores of the Chesapeake, and beamed to homes across America every Friday night.
This is a set of Homicide here in Fells Point. This building used to be an old recreation pier where they held ballroom dances, but now it's a home of Baltimore's own TV show.
The glitz and glamour of Hollywood and the hardcore reality of life on the streets of Maryland's biggest city has come together for the past 5 years on the set of Homicide.
And background, camera.
On this season's finale, Maryland's real-life governor and Baltimore's real-life mayor set aside politics to do some play acting. They portrayed themselves in a scene honoring one of the fictional homicide detectives who was murdered.
The ultimate sacrifice made on behalf of our citizens.
There will definitely be a struggle over the Emmy this year.
Is that right?
I see it slipping out of my hands. The governor's going to be nominated, the mayor's going to be nominated, I'm going to be nominated, and the governor's going to win.
The governor already feels the state's the winner by having this high-profile show have its permanent home in Maryland.
The finances, what it does to the economy here, the employment and money spend, $27 million that gets right into the Baltimore-Maryland economy.
I don't think that it's done to Baltimore what Miami Vice did to the city of Miami in terms of image. I think it's been really more positive.
Mayor Schmoke and Governor Glendinning look at Homicide as a good citizen in the state of Maryland that they want to stay around for many years to come. In Baltimore, Horace Holmes, News 7.
Thanks, Horace.
So you see
A drug suspect's attempt to run from the law doesn't get him very far. We're going to have the dramatic video of the high-speed chase when News 7 continues.
And a public apology from President Clinton and the victims, to the victims, rather, of the infamous Tuskeegee experiment. But first, here's Jeff.
All right, Paul, we've dropped into the 50s tonight. I'll let you know in just a little bit if we're going to be warming back up for the weekend. Rennie?
Well, Jeff, in sports, Alonzo Mourning didn't lose his invitation to the big garden party tonight. I've got the latest as the Heat battle the undermanned Knicks.
I'm Ted Koppel. Tonight on Nightline, the first time we went to outer space, we didn't expect to find life. Now we're looking for it. Are we flirting with disaster? And do we really want to bring it home tonight?
Closed captioning is brought to you as a public service by the makers of Centrum. Centrum's commitment to research ensures you always get the latest nutritional support. Centrum, always complete from A to Zinc.
What's the easiest way to get out of a 4x4? Get into this instead. The Audi A6 Quattro. With Quattro all-wheel drive, it's what more and more 4x4 owners are getting into and out of every day. Only Quattro, only from Audi.
Get ready for something deliciously zesty. It's Domino's new pesto crust pizza. We take sweet basil, parsley, and garlic and make that savory pesto taste and knead it right into the dough. And after baking, the crust is brushed with olive oil and sprinkled with Romano cheese, giving it that zesty flavor of authentic Italian pesto. Calling it a large one topping, just $9.99. New pesto crust pizza, only from Domino's. Domino's.
What if there was something that could keep your family safer? And what if it was recycled more than anything else on Earth? Wouldn't you want to have more of it around you? Well, now you can. The new steel. Feel the strength.
Welcome back.
Just announced, the great percent event is on at your local Ford dealers. Now get incredibly low 1.9% financing on Escort, Contour, Taurus, Thunderbird, and the all-new ZX2. That's 1.9% APR for 48 months, which can save you up to $4,300 in finance charges. Or choose cash back. $1,000 cash on Escort, Taurus, and Thunderbird. $2,000 cash on Taurus SHO. So hurry. With the most repeat buyers, we often say,
welcome back.
Call 1-540-371-3999 for more information.
A presidential apology tonight for the survivors of a medical study that used black men as guinea pigs.
Hundreds of African-American men who were poor were treated for treatment for syphilis to see what would happen to them in the now infamous Tuskeegee experiment. President Clinton apologized for the nation today for that study that was conducted with federal funds. Six of the eight survivors were present at today's ceremony. The Tuskeegee experiment began in the 1930s and continued for more than 40 years. The families of the victims say the gesture is appreciated.
I believe you would appreciate the apology. I believe you would have said it's something that should have taken place a long time ago.
More than 128 men died of syphilis during that study. After a long legal battle, the participants in the Tuskegee experiment and their families were awarded $10 million from the federal government. Tonight, a drug suspect is in serious condition after a high-speed chase today on the Florida Turnpike. Police chased the man who was stopped for drug possession for more than an hour at speeds topping 100 miles per hour. The suspect's car finally hit another car, flipped, and skidded out of control. Paramedics had to pry the man out of his flattened car. If he survives, he will face a number of charges.
The Space Shuttle Atlantis made an important delivery tonight. The seven astronauts on Atlantis hooked up with the Russian space station Mir to drop off much-needed supplies, including an oxygen generator, to make sure the crew members have breathable air. That is important. The generator will be installed this weekend. Atlantis is also making an astronaut exchange, picking up astronaut Jerry Liniger and leaving Mike Foley in his place. And a native son returned home to display his latest works of jazzy art before a star-spangled crowd tonight. Robert Freeman, a world-renowned artist from D.C., was on hand for the premiere of his latest work of art, Jazzy Series, at the Zenith Gallery in Northwest Washington. Gallery owner Marjorie Goldberg hosted many local celebrities tonight, fans and friends of Freeman now teaching at Harvard. The works of another local artist, sculptor Barton Rubenstein, also on display. The exhibit will be at the Zenith Gallery until June 15th, and his works are, of course, world-renowned. Fantastic, and many people don't know, but he's born and raised right here in the Washington area. Wonderful artist.
Great.
Yeah.
If you love airplanes, the place to be this weekend is going to be Andrews Air Force Base. And when News 7 continues, we'll have a preview of the annual air show out there.
And will the weather hold out for the air show and other events happening this weekend? Important stuff. Jeff Gilbert has that answer. Straight ahead.
Springtime on planet Mercury means one thing, the Planet Mercury Cosmic Sales Event. With low 1.9% APR financing for up to 48 months on all Mercury cars in stock, including the front-wheel drive Mercury Sable with a powerful V6 standard. Or drive off with 1.9% financing on Tracer, Mystique, Cougar, or Grand Marquis. But the Planet Mercury Cosmic Sales Event won't last long, so beam yourself to your Mercury dealer today.
Cops decided my client was going to be executed.
Rex Reed calls Night Falls on Manhattan one of those rare films with impact and insight.
If their lips are moving, they're lying.
It keeps you riveted.
Your father's clean.
Sidney Lumet is still one of the most important filmmakers of our time. Andy Garcia, Richard Dreyfuss.
Swear to me right here, Pop. You're clean.
Night Falls on Manhattan, rated R. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
Welcome to voicemail. To listen to messages, push 3. To record, push 1. To regain a sense of balance in your life, push 5. To shed the trappings of the modern world, push 8.
Leave the world behind with up to $2,000 cash back or 1.9% APR financing on a 97 Rodeo during the Isuzu Great Escape event, which just got even greater with exceptional offers on every Isuzu vehicle we sell.
To vanish without a trace, push 7, then star.
These colors speak for my intentions. Your colors are your own inventions. Color me. Stripes are straight like lines of love and line. You make a stripe above stripes. Look at the colored lines. My heart is many stripes.
This new 7 weather report is brought to you by Häagen-Dazs Ice Cream.
On a scale of 1 to 10, Jeff is giving this weekend a 9. Sounds great.
I might have taken it down to an 8 between the last two shows.
Uh-oh.
Anya, but nah, it's going to be up there pretty high. We're just a little concerned about tomorrow morning, I think, and again, a late Sunday. But I'll tell you in detail what I'm talking about here in a second. Let's take a look at current conditions at National Airport. We have a beautiful evening. We have clear skies reported across the region, low humidity, winds have died down, and the barometer is steady this hour at 29.96, but the pollen count is incredibly high today, again, at 212 for tree pollen. Our official high and low, that's the wrong low. 53, I think, was the low. But 67, the official high at National Airport, compared to the average of 76. And there you see the record high of 93 set back in 1911. So just a little cooler than normal. Plenty of stars, clear skies around the east this evening. Cold front that passed a day and a half ago is well out to sea. We're under the influence of relatively high pressure. But now we have just a very small system that wants to move through here. Skirt north of us tomorrow morning. We may grab the southern edge of that tomorrow morning in the way of clouds and some widely scattered, very light sprinkles. So if you go into the air show early, it may not be good flying weather to see some of these planes, but then again, we expect the conditions to improve by late morning and be pretty good for the afternoon. Here's the stuff we're talking about. It's in Michigan right now, northern Indiana, pressing into Ohio. And earlier today, the northern half of Wisconsin and the UP of Michigan received 1 to 2 inches of snow out of that. And now it's mainly rain with a little bit of snow mixed in as it moves through New York and Pennsylvania. And we will be on the southern edge of that in the morning, and so that will probably mean that you wake up to clouds. As we put the satellite picture into motion, notice all the clouds in the nation south, much of the nation clear. There's that little disturbance as it moves in. Bigger storm swirling around up there over southeast Canada, and that one is moving well off the picture as well. 58 degrees at National, 54 in Columbus. You see, there's not a real big temperature difference out to the west of us and to the north of us, and that's good news because this air tomorrow replacing the stuff we have in here now, really not too much different in the temperature department. We look for the overall condition to be warm. You see the blues indicating the cooler temperatures. We have some warm stuff that will be moving in for us, especially by Sunday. All right, here's how the forecast looks for this evening. We're starting out clear. We'll pick up a few clouds with that disturbance that will be moving in by morning. Our winds continue to diminish. It'll be quite cool this evening in the suburbs in early morning hours of 45 with about 50 for a low here in the district. Now tomorrow, expect some clouds in the morning, possibly a very light sprinkle, but then the sun should break out and the balance of the day should be good, 71 to 75 for a high. And Sunday doesn't look bad either. Plenty of sunshine, just a few fair weather clouds, 77 for a high. And then as we get into the early part of next week, maybe a shower by Tuesday, but warmer temperatures, possibly 83. By the day on Monday.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Can you live with that?
I think so. What time do you think those showers are going to break tomorrow morning?
Oh, anytime from pre-dawn to about 9, 10 o'clock, and then I think we'll be clear after,
after that, we're cool.
Good.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Not like you're going to be awake for that.
I'm sorry, but I am an early riser.
Are you really?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I am an early
riser. I won't see the rain then.
12,
plan to get up around 12.
Every day,
so it's been a long night. That's what it is. Yeah. Up next is sports. Unbelievable endings in Atlanta and right here at RFK. I've got the latest. Plus, with his buddy Patrick Ewing at home, Zoe goes right at the Knicks. Hoop highlights are on the way.
We'll be right back.
They said we couldn't create a low-fat ice cream delicious enough to be called Häagen-Dazs. Or make a low-fat ice cream creamy enough to carry the Häagen-Dazs name. But we did it. Introducing the only low-fat ice cream good enough to be called Häagen-Dazs. Everything they said you couldn't get in a low-fat ice cream with just 3 grams of fat per serving. New Häagen-Dazs low-fat ice cream. It's just perfect.
There's a car just waiting to be discovered.
Wow.
Rich in quality and reliability. Embellished with standard features like air conditioning, an AM/FM stereo, and an automatic transmission. And available at a price that's a true revelation. The 97 Accord Value Package.
Nice.
See your Honda dealer today.
See this? It's the Hub's main event circular. And inside are the most significant savings on brand name furniture you'll see this year. Anywhere. Like this sofa, on sale for $200 off our usual low price. Or this oak bed wall, just $6.99. So if you're looking for a real sale, a sale with significant savings, a sale with 6 months no interest financing, come to the Hub's main event. We'll even throw in a collapsible tent with every purchase.
This is a Big Mac.
This is my dad, Jim Delagatti.
This is my dad, Jim Delagatti. He created the world's greatest burger.
12 beef patties. There's cheese in there.
Special sauce. Very special. Very secret.
This is a Homicide meal.
Right now, buy a drink and fries. Any drink, any fries, any size. And get a Big Mac for just 55 cents.
55 cents.
To salute 1955, the year it all began.
This is a very good idea.
This won't be around forever.
This sesame seed is bigger than my head. This is my McDonald's.
Tonight's New 7 Sports Report is brought to you by New Dodge Dealers.
Is that good? Yeah, my Guillermo Villas and Kathleen, we want you here. I can sing a song for you. You can have a good time. Come and see us.
There's your invitation, Kathleen. Guillermo wants you to come out to the Corral Championship.
I'll go out there.
Come on out there.
Yeah, yeah.
Who got second round tomorrow?
The picture there.
But, you know, I keep that picture in my office.
Oh, I see.
See, that way I practice my anchoring in between shows. Like, well, Kathleen, I think it's huge. It's huge. Let's talk some basketball.
All right.
Huge game tonight in New York. This was something to see. No doubt the suspensions hurt the Knicks tonight. Ewing, Houston, and Ward did not play. And yet they lost to Miami by only 5. Patrick Ewing's absence allowed Alonzo Mourning room to roam. Hustle helping New York hang tough. Excuse me, front row spectators. Heads up. Larry Johnson taking it strong into the lane. Check out the tough bucket over 2. It puts New York up 2. Knicks fans getting their groove on. But Miami stops the music. Buck Williams rejected by Alonzo Mourning. Miami is off to the other end. Check out the move by Tim Hardaway. You know, usually you get fries with a save. Miami pulling away with a 15-6 run. Dan Marley pulls up from way downtown. Bang. Heat up 83-76. Zoe from beyond the arch. Oh, don't you know. Mourning had 28 points and 9 rebounds. Miami wins 95-90, tying the series at 3. This move begs the question, is it hockey or pro wrestling? Rangers and Flyers game 1 of the NHL Eastern Conference Final. Eric Lindros playing fullback. Watch him block out 2 Rangers. That allows his man to score. Lindros, a major factor in the Phillies offense. A Phillies offense, that is. He lures the defense, then passes to a wide open Yanni Minola. Happy, happy, joy, joy. Flyers win game 1, 3-1. The Orioles have made the trek up the West Coast. They're at Seattle tonight, leading 4-1 in the fourth inning. Roberto Alomar has 2 RBIs for Baltimore so far. Alan Bannis with his own rendition of You Can't Touch This tonight. The Cards pitcher working a no-hitter into the ninth inning. 2 outs, Michael Tucker up, and he does what those before him could not. Tucker drives it deep to center field. The ball drops in, ending the no-hitter. The Cardinals and Braves remain scoreless presently in the 12th inning of play. Tiger Woods had the round, but this guy had the shot today. Doug Martin, the tee shot of the 17th at the Byron Nelson Classic, over the fairway, onto the green, and into the cup. Raise your hands, Doug. You've got a hole in one. Tiger Woods smoking the course today. He shot a 29 on the front 9, 10 under par as he made the turn. Tiger finished with a round of 6 under 64. He is tied with Lee Rinker for the lead at 12 under par. More sports to come. Redskins Darrell Green defies the laws of gravity. As we go to break, the United come through in the kick of time. DC hosting Leeds. Final minute of and a half of play. John Mazner boosts the ball across to Tony Sinna, who one times a bouncer into the net. The exhibition game ended in a 1-1 tie. We'll be right back.
Of all the features that have made Dodge Caravan America's best-selling minivan, nothing has been as user-friendly as our revolutionary second sliding door. And now, you can get this second sliding door at no extra charge. Announcing the National Dodge Sale, it's never been easier to get into and out of America's favorite minivan. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Circuit City's 48th anniversary sale is going on now, and you'll pay no interest till 1998 on all Sony purchases $4.99 and up, all Hitachi 8mm camcorders, and all RCA 8mm camcorders $4.49 and up. Like this RCA 8mm camcorder, just $449.99. And if you're looking for a new computer, you'll get a $300 price break on this Toshiba laptop, now just $1299.99, only during Circuit City's 48th anniversary sale.
Chance.
Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. Instead, bolt out of here and take a real chance to win $25,000 of real money. So advance to a Virginia Lottery retailer and play the Instant Monopoly game. Watch the cat.
The Instant Monopoly game, a real chance to win $25,000.
Grab your jacket. No, the red one. That's it. Down the steps. Okay, get on the bus. Get directly on the bus.
Toyota is crunching the numbers again, so you can drive a new Avalon. Lease your Avalon for only $308 a month with $1,000 down cash or trade. You'll drive Toyota's luxury flagship, fully equipped with air conditioning, full power, and more. Or crunch your payments down to $263 a month with $2,000 down. You also get anti-lock brakes, cruise control, a full-size spare, and more. Avalon is a full-size value starting under $24,000. Get yours today.
37 years old and still in possession of his hops. Watch Redskin Darrell Green get up for the throwdown. But he appears a bit surprised by his abilities to levitate. The question is, can he dunk during competition? We'll find out tomorrow night at Hayfield High School. That's where we are playing a charity basketball game to benefit the Youth Life Foundation. Tip-off is 7 o'clock. Everybody, come on out and see if Darrell can indeed levitate.
Is it free?
No. See, we're trying to raise money. It's a fundraiser, so there's a small dwarf prize.
Well, tell me how much it is.
I don't know how much it is.
This is Joe Gibbs Foundation, right?
No, this is Gerald Green's
Youth Life Foundation. Okay.
Yes. All right. Thank you very much. We'll get over and see you. Have a great weekend.
I'll loan you some money to get in case you're
short.
Well,
I'm going to need some.
Well, do you still have some room on your weekend dance card? Because we have a high-flying idea you might find to your liking.
A preview of the annual air show at Andrews Air Force Base. Stay with us.
But Dad wouldn't lie.
Look, every Ford dealer says they're number one in sales. Right, Dad?
We didn't say that Tedbert Ford was number one.
See?
Ford says we're number one. Tedbert Ford, Route 50, Fairfax.
I decided to try this hot new color that all the magazines are raving about. I go to Rite Aid and pick it up. Ugh, it's horrible. Another one to add to the makeup junk drawer, right? Wrong. Rite Aid's got this new cosmetics money-back guarantee, and it's risk-free. You don't like it? Rite Aid gives you your money back. We all make mistakes buying cosmetics, but now we don't have to pay for them.
The Rite Aid Cosmetics Money-Back Guarantee. For your life, Rite Aid's got it.
The 97 Mazda Protege LX Sports Sedan, $12,995. Add cruise and power everything, and the price goes to... Add air conditioning, and the price jumps to... Add a CD player, and the price soars to... Add the best basic warranty in its class, and you get the idea. Now get the passion. $12,995.
On the next extra, how two grieving daughters of one of Sammy the Bull's victims are seeking revenge on their daddy's killer. Then, new witnesses to the Phoenix UFO sightings claim that seeing is believing. Only on Extra.
Tonight at 12:05 on Channel 7.
The drug, cocaine. The victims, defenseless animals, sacrificed in the name of science. Who's paying for it? You are. An exclusive I-Team investigation, Monday on News 7 at 11.
Sure, you can let anyone try to change your oil. Should have gone to Jiffy Lube.
Every 3,000 miles, just bring it into Jiffy Lube.
Looks like a pretty big selection to me.
Dad says Tedbert Ford has the biggest.
How many do you think there are?
How many stars in the sky? How many fish in the sea? How many?
There's one in every crowd.
Tedbert Ford, Route 50, Fairfax.
If you're still looking for something to do this weekend, you should look to the skies.
The 39th annual Joint Services Air Show will take place over the next 3 days. It all takes place at Andrews Air Force Base. That's in Maryland, of course. 700,000 people are expected to attend the show, which will feature vintage World War II airplanes as well as newer aircraft. The Air Force Thunderbirds and the Army Golden Knight Parachute Team will also be on hand.
Oh, yeah.
If you got some time, it's worth going out to see. You can get up close and personal with those airplanes as they sit along the flight line. I'd like to have you out there.
Got all these pilots and plane lovers here that are just salivating.
We'll be there.
That's it for News 7 at 11.
Stay tuned now for ABC's Nightline. We hope you have a great night. We'll see you. And a good weekend. See you on Monday.
Report to me by 5. Honey, 5.
You can kiss that promotion goodbye, Shorty.
Your accountant's on line 1. The audit next Tuesday.
Your wife's on 2. And where's the dry cleaning?
Yeah, where's the dry cleaning?
Life getting a bit overwhelming? Try the simple thrill of an Accord coupe. From Honda.
There's only one place you'll find the reliability of Craftsman mowers and tractors, Sears. And for 3 days only, there's no interest, no billing, and no payments for 3 months on all Craftsman tractors. Craftsman mowers and tractors help you cut your job down to size. And that takes the work out of yard work. 0% financing on Craftsman tractors through Saturday, only at Sears.
Woke up this morning and dragged myself out of bed. Went on into the kitchen, my fridge was a day. Got my chef dirty laundry, went down to my machine. That's when I discovered my clothes weren't even clean.
we've got the cure for your blues with 1 year no interest financing on all major appliances this week at Best Buy.
It's Brown's Great Car Giveaway. Win a brand new car or $20,000 cash. Just match your driver's license to the winning numbers posted at any of Brown's 15 locations. Call 1-888-800-BROWNS for the location nearest you. Check this weekend's post ads for Brown's near giveaway prices on thousands of vehicles. Come on down and see Brown's. First person in with a matching number wins. It could be you.
At Brown's.